I took flight training under the CPT program. Matter of fact, I took the course twice and had 450 hours when I decided to join the Coast Guard. And instead, the recruiter talked me into going to Navy, which is basically the same thing. And then when I got to Corpus Christi, the Marine Corps stuck their nose in it, and Colonel Lawrence talked me into going Marine Corps because I was in the top 10% of the class.
In the early morning of April 7th, 1943, a Japanese attack fleet was set for a major attack against the island of Guadalcanal, a major U.S. base in the Solomon Islands. Stationed on the island was 22-year-old James Swett, a Marine first lieutenant who had not yet seen his first combat action. His flight that day would bring the young pilot face to face with approximately 150 Japanese planes, an attack force on par with the first wave unleashed at Pearl Harbor.
My first combat earned me this medal. We had three flights that day. The first flight was pre-dawn, and there was nothing there. And the second flight, there was nothing there. And then we heard that there was 150 Japanese dive bombers headed for our fleet, which was over in Tulagi. We heard that they had zero escort. We have no idea how many zeros were in there. We were only eight planes, and we were told to orbit Florida, but the dive bombers got there before we did. The sky was black with them. They were all over the place. Smiley Burnett, he said, "My God, there's millions of them." He was right. I caught the first one just as he was pushing over and getting ready to dive. And I caught another one about halfway down, something like that. And then another one down at the bottom. About that time, the anti-aircraft shot a hole in my starboard wing and put me out of commission, thinking that, well, if they got, I got hit, maybe I can go home. But I was headed to getting away from the damned anti-aircraft when I found a whole bunch of dive bombers trying to get together, and they were scattered all over the sky. So I just take one and get down below them so the rear gunner couldn't get me, and just stick my nose up and short burst, and then he would catch on fire, and I'd go to the next one and do the same thing. Then I got overconfident after the sixth one went down. The rear gunner stuck his gun practically at my face and let me have it. Sight glass and plastic was flying all over the damn place. He shot out my oil cooler, and that said, "Well, okay, fellas, that's enough. I'm going to have to get the hell out of here." So I came back past the fleet and got out over the ocean and figured I could make it to Guadalcanal, but about that time the prop stopped. Uh-oh. So I had to make a water landing. The airplane hit and it bounced and then dove for the water, and I knew that I was in deep trouble. I went down, I don't know, maybe 20 feet or something like that. I was struggling to get out of the damn thing, and finally did, and popped my Mae West and came to the surface. About that time, the Coast Guard picket boat was offshore someplace. I don't know what he was doing. He came over and they all had rifles and they were pointed at me. And he said, "Are you an American?" My reply is not fit for family video. I said, "Yes, I am." I was scared to death that day. Just happened to look out and make the big one.
In a matter of minutes, Swett single-handedly destroyed seven enemy bombers, making him an ace on his very first combat engagement with the enemy.
Major General Ralph Mitchell was the commander of the 1st Marine Air Wing, and he decorated me with the medal. They had the whole dang air group out there, and flags flying all over the place, and God, I was shaking in my boots then. But when he put the medal around my neck, he said, Jim, this is the first time I've ever given the Medal of Honor. I said, it's the first time I ever got one, sir. And he laughed. Smart aleck, you know. I wound up the war with 15 and a half kills. And some of them I didn't like. War is just a terrible thing. And freedom is not free. And you've got to fight for it in order to keep it. We wear this medal basically for the veterans of all wars, for all services, for everything, particularly those who haven't returned.